On Wednesday, President Yoweri Museveni officially returned the Anti-Homosexuality Bill 2023 to Parliament for reconsideration, seeking revision of three contentious matters. The Committee on Legal and Parliamentary Affairs wasted no time to process this bill, and by close of business today, the report was ready.
The committee, it is normal for the President to send the bill back to the Speaker and ask that it should be reconsidered. So for us as a committee, it didn't shock us. This is normal legislative process.
According to credible sources, the committee chaired by the Gomba West Member of Parliament, Robin Aguremere Rwakojo, has been able to incorporate issues raised by the President and are ready to present the report to Parliament on Tuesday.
And we have agreed on what we are going to do. Tomorrow, we shall polish up our report. We shall discuss it, polish it up, and sign it. Because I don't think on Monday I'll get members to sign it, since it's a public holiday. And we are supposed to present on Tuesday morning.
We have learned that the West Budama Northeast MP Fox Odoi, who authored the minority report when Parliament was considering the Anti-Homosexuality Bill 2023, has authored another minority report dissenting from the position of the majority committee members' report.
I was given notice that we shall have a minority report, and that is good. Because, I mean, in terms of the notice that I was given, he's doing the right thing by informing me, because he's not supposed to surprise us. Yeah, we wouldn't have wanted a minority report, but he's not supposed to surprise us. So he has declared that he's coming up with a minority report.
Among other things, the president wants the law to criminalize the act of homosexuality, not someone's state of being homosexual. It seeks to expunge Clause 9, Subsection 1. Which penalizes persons who hire out their premises for homosexuality acts, and also review Clause 14 that imposes a duty on one to report suspected acts of homosexuality. This report has been filed by Fred Kajubi for the news from Parliament.